Yes, I'll try to focus on the buffalo. I know I have a straight smile at the moment, but I am tired. I stayed up till 2 o'clock last night, and I did the Linkadot collect name seaming together, and it worked. It was very wonderful. It was at the FamilySearch .com.org. Join it. It's wonderful. It's free, and it's a great database. And then the only thing is, you know, all the sources aren't there. So many are, you know, there's these huge link throughs, but then it all has to be somehow sourced. But it does work for my grandmother and my grandfather, and then here we are headed to the kingdom of England and headed to the kingdoms of France and Spain again. So I have like, what do we call that, at least the accolades of somebody else has gone there and done that and found it also. So that's good. Good for what? I don't know, because right now I'm just thinking about buffalo atrocities. What happened, since now I'm a Native American also, I'm thinking about what happened to the buffalo. And, you know, I remember the little glance over in history class, you know, when I was growing up in school. And then I'm like, well, let's go look at it up again, look it up. And there it is, it's 1.5 million were slaughtered. I'll put that little picture out here on the trailer front of this vlog. And yeah, 1.5, and that was the reason to, because, hey, you know, stop their food supply, and that was their idea. Stop their food supply, stop their stop them from living. Okay, so that was then, and that's terrible. And yes, the white man is insane. I am in full certainty of that, as I'm certain the insane white man exists today, to this day, and they do these things. And this type of event, you know, where they took 1.5 million buffalo and destroyed them, killed them, and put them in their heads, many of their heads, in a pile, they bathed in the glory of it. They have a glorification complex, perhaps. Maybe that's what the insane white man has, is a glorification complex, where he has to, and no matter how disgusting, he glorifies himself in those moments of heinous crimes. Yeah, so the insane white man. How do we bring them back, these buffalo? That's where I'm at. Forget this insane white man for the moment. And yeah, you guys invited him as your president. What do we do now to get the buffalo back? The buffalo were a key. You know, they were a key to this. I will say even a key to hurricanes. They were a key to the plains, the fertilization. It's just like you took all of your manure away, your natural manure, from the entire middle of the United States. There's no manure now. You took it away. I mean, these were vast herds, and they just walked around and ran around and raised their young in these desolate places. And they made things grow, you know, they made things grow. They made the pines grow. They made what even exists today in Colorado, you know, the mountains, all of these things. They helped. They were the, you know what I mean? So they took them away, and, anyway. So if we bring them back, it's a natural fertilizer, we bring them back, and They're not the regular cattle. They're not running with those regular they're going to be a whopper or whatever. No, bring them back as wild buffalo. Simple. Just have wild buffalo. I mean, they're not even gonna get in your way. They're not gonna hurt you. They're not gonna do anything except be wild buffalo out there on a plain. I mean, why not revitalize that? Okay. And so when we revitalize the buffalo herds, what else do we do? Well, we change the climate. We change the climate. Because all of that manure, all those new fresh worms, more rain attraction. We're having rain attraction now because of the moisture content additive. We're having a different middle of the United States now. It's starting to feel a little more microclimate. A microclimate environment where you have more diversity of plants growing. And in that, what else happens? Well, you can definitely cut down on the wind, and we have terrible winds all throughout. Now I don't know. I mean, I don't know the studies, if they had studies back then before the buffalo, when they had the buffalo. How bad were the hurricanes? How bad were the tornadoes to how they are today with no buffalo? So we could very well have given ourselves here in this United States tornadoes extra. We could have given ourselves desertification. Not could, definitely. Given ourselves desertification extra. So anyway, so that's my take on it, is we have to bring them back. Those 1.5 million, we need them back. Just bring them back. And we will fix and mend this planet a little bit more. Okay?